Namaste. In this learning dialogue, we will learn about evolution of aryloxypropanolamine as beta blocker. Beta blockers are among the most widely employed antihypertensive and are also considered the first line treatment for glaucoma. Most of the beta blockers are in the chemical class of aryloxypropanolamine. The first beta blocker, dichloroisoproterenol, was developed by considering isoproterenol as lead. ISO is non-selective and prototypical beta agonist. The presence of isopropyl group on nitrogen atom confers increased beta activity and no alpha activity. TCI differs structurally from ISO in that the agonist directing 3-4 dihydroxy groups have been replaced by 2 chloro groups. Unfortunately, TCI is not a pure antagonist but a partial agonist. The substantial direct sympathomimetic action of DCI precluded its development as a clinically useful drug. Pronethalol was the next important beta blocker developed. Although it had much less intrinsic sympathomimetic activity than DCI, it was withdrawn from clinical testing because of reports that it caused thymic tumor in mice. Within 2 years of this report, the beta blocking action of propranolol were described, a close structural relative of pronethalol. It is the standard against which all other beta blockers are compared. Propranolol is a prototypical and non-selective beta blocker in the chemical class of aryloxypropanolamines. An OCH2 group is being incorporated into the molecule between the aromatic ring and ethyl aminoside chain. Because this structural feature is frequently found in beta blockers, the assumption is made that the OCH2 group is responsible for the antagonist property of the molecules. However, this is not true. In fact, the OCH2 group is present in several compounds that are potent beta agonists. Now, pause the video for 2 minutes. After looking to this 4 structure, think of structural feature required for beta antagonist activity and note down in your course journal. Okay, let's see the important structural feature. It is the nature of aromatic ring and its substituents that is primarily determinant of beta antagonist activity. Note the side chain in propranolol has been moved from C2 to C1 position from the naphthyl ring. The nature of aromatic ring is also determinant in their beta 1 selectivity. One common structural feature of many cardioselective beta blockers is the presence of a para substituent of sufficient size on aromatic ring along with the absence of meta substituent. Practolol is a prototypical example of beta 1 blocker of this structural type. It was the first cardioselective beta 1 blocker to be used extensively in humans. Because it produced several toxic effects, it is no longer in general use. The aryl group also affects the absorption, excretion and metabolism of the beta blockers. Like beta agonist. The beta directing tertiary butyl and isopropyl group are normally found on the amino function of aryl oxypropanolamine beta blockers. It must be a secondary amine for optimal activity. For beta blockers, the beta hydroxy substituted carbon must be in S absolute configuration for maximal beta blocking activity. Because of the insertion of an oxygen atom in the side chain of aryl oxypropanol amines, the priority of the substituents around the asymmetric carbon differs from the agonist. The pharmacologically more active enantiomer of beta blocker interacts with receptor recognition site in the same manner as that of the agonist. In spite of the fact that nearly all of the beta blocking activity resides in one enantiomer, propranolol and most other beta blockers are used clinically as racemic mixture. The only exceptions are levobunolol, timolol and penbutolol, with which the S isomer is used. Propranolol is the most lipophilic drug among the available beta blocker, and thus it enters CNS much better than the less lipophilic drugs such as atenolol or nadolol. The use of lipophilic beta blocker such as propranolol has been associated with more CNS side effects such as dizziness, confusion or depression. These side effects can be avoided, however, with the use of hydrophilic drugs such as atenolol or nadolol. To summarize, in this learning dialogue, we have studied about how propranolol is developed as a prototype beta blocker and the structural features which are important for beta antagonist property. They are the nature of aromatic ring and its substituent, the nature of amino function, the configuration of beta hydroxy substituted carbon, and some side effects related to lipophilicity of the beta blocker. Thank you.